This time, I'm going to talk about how to build a simple ZeroMQ in C#. Synchronous and asynchronous messaging are two different communication models used in computer systems and distributed applications. They define how messages or requests are exchanged between components or systems and how the sender and receiver interact in terms of timing and response. In synchronous messaging, the sender of a message expects an immediate response from the receiver before proceeding further. The sender blocks and waits for the response, typically halting its execution until the response is received. This means that the sender and receiver are synchronized and operate in a lockstep manner. In asynchronous messaging, the sender of a message does not wait for an immediate response from the receiver. Instead, it continues its execution independently without blocking or halting. The sender and receiver operate independently of each other and do not need to be in sync. Using the same client-server example, in asynchronous messaging, the client sends a request to the server and continues with its own tasks without waiting for a response. ZeroMQ is a high-performance asynchronous messaging library that allows distributed applications to communicate with each other over various transport protocols. It provides a lightweight and flexible architecture for building scalable and efficient messaging systems. I summarized the key features of ZeroMQ here. ZeroMQ is designed to be lightweight and efficient, with minimum overhead and low latency. And also, ZeroMQ abstracts the underlying network transport, allowing applications to communicate over various protocols such as TCP, UDP, IPC, and in-process communication. ZeroQ supports various programming languages listed here, and also ZeroMQ supports several messaging patterns, including one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-many communication models. I'll talk about more about messaging patterns in detail in the next slide. Also, ZeroMQ has very good fault tolerance and scalability. As I mentioned in my previous slide, ZeroMQ supports several messaging protocols. It supports request, reply, publish, subscribe, push, pull, exclusive pair, and it supports pipeline, survey, and also message broker. NetMQ is a C# port of ZeroMQ and provides a lightweight messaging library for .NET applications. In this video, I will show you how to install NetMQ on Windows 10 PC and how to build a ZeroMQ application. First, you need to install Visual Studio. You can download Visual Studio 2019 or the latest version from the official Microsoft website. And then you can create a new project and you right click on the project in the Solution Explorer and select Manage NuGet Packages. And then you can search NetMQ and you click on the install button and install the NetMQ package. After the installation, you can verify your NetMQ package under the dependencies section of your project in the Solution Explorer. I will show you how to check that later. Then you can start to write your application by using ZeroMQ with NetMQ library. Now, let's take a look at ZeroMQ website. You can go to zeromq.org website. You can see ZeroMQ is an open source universal messaging library. And if you click Get Started, you come to here, and there are some documentations, and also you can download ZeroMQ from this website. And if you go underneath, you can pick your language. In this video, I'm going to show you how to implement ZeroMQ in C#. So I click C#. You can see here, we have the code for the server. We have the code for the client. So I'm going to implement that in my C# application. In this solution, I created two projects already. One is ZeroMQ client, another one is ZeroMQ server. Then, how can we install this NetMQ package? You can click on one of the projects, right-click it, and you can see there is an item called Manage NuGet Packages. You click that, and then you can search NetMQ. You see, because I already installed NetMQ, so I can uninstall it. Now I won't uninstall it, but if you haven't installed NetMQ, it will show you something like this. It shows version and install. You click the install button and you can install NetMQ. And after you install it, you can open dependencies, packages. You can see NetMQ shows up here. And also similarly, for this ZeroMQ server project, you can also install this NetMQ package. But for the same package, you don't want to install twice. You want to share the same package for all your projects. Then how can you do that? If you want to use the same NetMQ package without reinstalling it for each project, you can take advantage of a feature called Package Reference in Visual Studio. I will not read through all the messages here. And basically, when you click each project, it will show you the reference like this. And if you want to share this NetMQ package, you just write private access equal to all like this. Let me show you in my Visual Studio. If you click this ZeroMQ client project, by default, it will show you something like this. It will show you package reference include NetMQ with the version number. And if you want to share this NetMQ package, all you need to do is to add private access equal to all. And the same thing for this ZeroMQ server project, you also do the same thing. Just add a string here. And also, you need to right-click your solution and click Properties. And make sure when you start your project, you start multiple startup projects. In my case, I will start ZeroMQ client and ZeroMQ server at the same time. And if you check my C# program, you can see this code is copied from here. Basically, it's the same code. Now, let's check out the program. For this ZeroMQ client, this is a program. First, it will connect to Hello World server, and it uses the TCP protocol at port 5555. And then it will send hello. And after it got the message back, it will write received word. And for the server, you can see if it received a message, it will write received hello. Now let's run the program. For the client, you can see we're connecting to Hello World server and then sending hello. This is the count 0, 1, 2, 3. And we receive the response and with the count. Received word 0, received word 1. And for this server, we can check the program is this. And it shows received hello, like that. This is how you can build a simple ZeroMQ in C#. Please provide your comments and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.